Since her rise to stardom in the 90s, Salma Hayek has come to be known as somewhat of a sex symbol due to her incredible good looks and her ample bosom. While the star has never shied away from embracing this status, she's also worked hard to transcend it. In addition to being a Hollywood actress, she's also a very successful producer. Her production company, Ventanarosa, has produced such notable hits as 2002's Frida and the 2006 TV show Ugly Betty. Hayek's works as a producer have always been thought-provoking and never afraid to push boundaries. Her most recent show, A Boob's Life, on HBO Max is no exception. Join Factsverse as we take a look at why Salma Hayek's boobs are getting their own TV show. Salma Hayek came to Hollywood in the 90s with a lot of talent and a ton of ambition. However, she had few resources. The young actress barely spoke English, and she suffered from dyslexia. She had trouble reading street signs, let alone Hollywood scripts. However, this was a problem the actress was quick to overcome. She was discovered by up-and-coming director Robert Rodriguez and cast in two of his films. These were 1995's Desperado and 1996's From Dusk Till Dawn. In addition to her talents as an actress, both films made liberal use of the actress's incredible good looks. In Desperado, she portrayed the love interest of the main protagonist. In From Dusk Till Dawn, she played a vampire stripper and was given an extensive dance sequence during the middle of the film. Before arriving in Hollywood, Hayek had achieved some success in soap operas that aired in her native country of Mexico. She had enough success there, she felt confident enough that she could make it in Hollywood. Despite initial setbacks, her confidence ended up paying off. Before achieving her major successes, though, Hayek had to work on her English-speaking abilities so she could get wordier roles. It didn't take her long to get a solid enough grasp of the language to start taking prominent speaking parts. Her success with Robert Rodriguez led to her procuring roles that utilized more of her diverse talents. In 1999, she was cast in director Kevin Smith's film Dogma. While she had played a vampire stripper in From Dusk Till Dawn, in Dogma, she played an apostle. In addition to this role, 1999 also gave her a starring turn in a major Hollywood blockbuster. This was Wild Wild West, a loose adaptation of the 60s television show. She starred alongside Will Smith and Kevin Kline. Although the film was poorly received, Hayek herself was praised. Following the mainstream recognition, she began appearing in more and more films. However, she also took the opportunity to kickstart her own production company, Ventanarosa. In 2002, Ventanarosa produced Frida, a biopic of Mexican artist Frida Kahlo. Hayek gave herself the starring role, and it allowed her to showcase her diversity as an actress. It appears Hayek was not only a talented performer, but a sharp businesswoman behind the scenes as well. Hayek hired a female director, Julie Taymor, to direct the film. Hayek's performance was nominated for an Academy Award, further solidifying her status as more than just a sex symbol. She continued her work as a Hollywood actress while also raising her status as a notable producer behind the scenes. In 2006, Ventanarosa had another hit on their hands with the TV series Ugly Betty. The show lasted 4 seasons and was a major success. In addition to providing solid comedy and drama, it also challenged the audience's conception of what it meant to be considered beautiful in today's world. Since that show came to an end in 2010, Hayek has been itching to get back into television. Now it appears that Hayek and Ventanarosa have found another project to get behind, and one that looks as if it's going to be at least as groundbreaking as Ugly Betty. That project is A Boob's Life, which Ventanarosa will be producing for HBO Max as a half-hour comedy series. Based off the title alone, people may wonder what the show's about, but they'd probably have a hard time guessing correctly. A Boob's Life will be adapted from a non-fiction book by Leslie Lair called A Boob's Life: How America's Obsession Shaped Me and You. The show will share the themes of the book, but will channel them into a fictional narrative. It will follow the comedic misadventures of a 40-year-old woman whose boobs can talk to her. Apparently, her boobs have some fairly insightful information to share with her about the world, which forces the woman to start viewing her life a little bit differently. Although the series will tackle some heavy issues, it will be a light half-hour comedy that both men and women can enjoy. The main character's name is Leslie, and no actress has been confirmed for the role yet. However, the 54-year-old Hayek could easily pass for 40. A showrunner has been named. Hayek has given the job to writer Cynthia Mort. Whether TV audiences recognize the name or not, they're likely familiar with some of her work. Cynthia Mort rose to prominence as a writer on such shows as Will and Grace and Roseanne during her early years in the industry. The writer also has previous experience with HBO, having created the series Tell Me You Love Me in 2007. So, from the looks of it, it appears Salma Hayek's boobs are in good hands. Hey, if you're enjoying this video so far, be sure to hit the like button to show your support. And subscribe to Facts First for more. Author Leslie Lair has always had a fascination with boobs. Not only boobs themselves, but the impact boobs have had on both history and popular culture. As compared to the narrative show that's taking its name, Lair's book aims to serve as a history of America's obsession with boobs. And it will explore how that obsession has shaped the experience of women in the country. The book combines Lair's own personal experiences with narratives from history that relate to the experience. Lair has battled with breast cancer, and her breasts mean more to her than simple objects to be ogled. However, she maintains a positive relationship with them and her body. Her book is a love letter to both boobs and the gender that bears them. If Leslie wanted to talk about boobs, she picked the perfect partner. Salma Hayek rose to prominence in roles that utilized her good looks to draw in the audience. The actress is certainly no stranger to being objectified by men. When it came time to adapt Lair's book to TV, Hayek and Lair decided to add the comedic narrative. They felt fictionalizing the show and adding comedy could increase viewership, allowing them to spread their message to a greater number of people. In addition to pushing the boundaries of both film and TV with her works as a producer, Hayek isn't afraid to own her image as a sexy woman. Recently, the star went on a vacation and flaunted a bikini on the beach in a private photo shoot. Hayek had prepared for weeks for the vacation, losing weight and exercising so she could look her absolute best for the photos. The plan worked, and the star has been gradually revealing the photos from the shoot on her Instagram page. However, she's been more than open about the fact she doesn't always look that fit. According to her, she, quote, had to lose a lot of weight and do a lot of exercise to get into the bikini. Hayek said she began her exercise and diet regimen towards the end of 2020 in preparation for her vacation. She went on to say that, to her, deciding to share the bikini photos on Instagram was liberating. But she pointed out she was not in the same condition anymore, meaning she likely gave up a good deal of her exercise and diet regimen after her vacation came to an end. Still, the actress seems to have barely aged since her introduction to Hollywood in the 90s. Her last few uploads to Instagram have gotten millions of likes each. Although Hayek is certainly a proactive feminist, one can assume she appreciates her fans' appreciation for her good looks. Although Salma Hayek is certainly a beautiful and talented actress, she's also much more. The star had never intended on being known just for her good looks and acting abilities. Her real dream, according to her, was to start her own company, which she did with Ventanarosa. As she put it, the reason she wanted to start her own company was not only so that she could make projects for herself, but so that she could create projects for other Latin women. It was a tough battle for the star in her early days. She has shared that when coming to Hollywood for the first time, she had an accent, she was dyslexic, and was also short and chubby. Although fans might roll their eyes at the short and chubby part, it's not hard to empathize with the star's negative perception of her body during her early career. Over time, she has gained a better self-image and has looked to share body positivity with her fans and audience. Salma Hayek has certainly proved herself to be a viable artist, both on and off the screen. Comment below to share your favorite role from Hayek's Hollywood career, or if you're excited to check out A Boob's Life on HBO Max. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to Facts First for more. Click the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest content.